288, please stand.
Reverend Father in God, Leo, by the divine permission, Bishop of the Church and See of the Holy Trinity, in great claims, commands, and charges all and singular here present for the receiving of the holy order of priesthood, that no one of them who may chance to be unbaptized or unconfirmed, irregular or else excommunicate, under interdict or suspension, whether in canon law or by judicial sentence, that no one who is infamous or in any other way by canon law disqualified, or without duly having been registered, examined, tried, approved, and summoned by name, do presume in any wise to come forward and receive this sacred order, and that none of the ordained depart until they have received the Holy Communion, and the communion service being ended, they have received the bishop's blessing.
Please be seated. Let the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be always acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters, today is the celebration of the solemnity of the Blessed Trinity, God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. God the Father, our Creator, God the Son, our Redeemer, God the Holy Spirit, our Sanctifier, who continues to sanctify the Church until the second coming of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Today also is a great occasion for us to be celebrating the ordination of Deacon Steve Messias into the Holy Order of Priesthood. So, you see before us, there are three orders, namely deacon, priest, and bishop being present. And why? Why do we need these three orders? Because they were instituted by the apostles through the apostolic succession, and that's how our church was served from the time Christ ascended into heaven and sent the Holy Spirit from the day of Pentecost onwards. That is the style of our church's functioning. Why? To offer to God true worship decently and in order, at the same time to administer to the people the sacraments, the channels of God's loving and living grace to all of us. Pondering on the Trinity, St. Augustine the Great, we would know him from the 4th century, was walking down on a seashore in his episcopal garments and pondering about God being three persons and yet one God. How could that be? He found a little lad running across, digging a hole on the shore, going to the ocean, bringing the ocean water in a small shell and filling the hole. And he was doing it constantly. Augustine stopped him and said, "What are you doing?" "Well, I'm trying to fill this entire ocean in this little hole." And then Augustine said, "How can that be possible?" "Well, yes, just as I cannot, perhaps, in your mind, fill the entire ocean into this hole, so how could you get the tremendous power and the mystery of the Blessed Trinity into your little head?" Saying so, he vanished. I think it's a very powerful all of our present, our past, and our future. Only God knows, because He is. And this is the mystery that we behold as we celebrate the Blessed Trinity. And Christ established His church, and to begin with, there were just a dozen people. Even one fell short of that. There were only 11 to begin with, on the day of Pentecost, and then the apostles gathered together and chose the 12th one. And yet, these 12 people, filled with the power of the Holy Spirit, were able to go to the four corners of the earth and spread Christianity. I stand here from India, where St. Thomas the Apostle brought Christian faith 2,000 years ago, not centuries. So it is wonderful to see how God has worked so beautifully in the lives of faithful. However, the Son of God had a warning for us. When the Son of Man returns, will he find enough faith on this earth? So our task and our duty is to preserve the faith once delivered unto the saints, to protect this faith and pass on to the future generation. Yes, we may be few, but we are faithful, and that is what counts. So when the Son of Man returns, he should be finding us faithfully serving him. So we come to the ordination today from the pondering on the Blessed Trinity, that God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit are just not intellectual concepts, but they are real persons, three persons and yet one God. And it is Him we worship. If we were to ask Britain in 1940. And the story goes that there was a communist government trying to drive out every vestige of relic or a church or a symbol, anything that was there, totally be destroyed. And several of the clergy also gave up their faith because the government was so tenacious and coming down on the throats of people that they gave up their faith. There was one priest, however, was dodging this communist government. He was seen going around conducting the Holy Eucharist and giving people the sacraments, and the communist government, somehow they could not get hold of him. But they do get hold of him, finally. He's killed, and as he's killed, there is news that there is another priest like him who's doing God's work. The kingdom of God is compared by the Lord Jesus to a tiny mustard seed, and yet when that seed is sown, when it grows, it becomes a beautiful tree, nesting all the birds of the air and providing home for them. That is what the kingdom of God is likened to. And we, though fallible offenders, miserable offenders, as we pray in the prayer book, you know, yet we are called to be conduits of God's grace. And that's why this sacred order of deacon, priest, and bishop. And so, as we celebrate today, we ponder on the threes: God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. It's very beautiful. And also, we ponder on three: St. Paul's, the school, Canterbury School, and the priest who is being ordained to serve. Church, when we come together to worship the Lord. And the tradition is in the apostolic tradition, Acts chapter 2, verse 40 through 42. The early members gather together, listening to God's word, listening to the teachings of the apostles, in the breaking of bread, and fellowshipping with one another. And that is what is being continued even to this day. And it is a wonderful coming together of Deacon Steve Macias, who is willingly come forward, and I must appreciate and thank his beloved wife, Sarah, who has been very instrumental in supporting him towards this endeavor. And we pray that God's grace, His Spirit, and His presence may be with us during this holy service. And without any further ado, we will enter into the celebration of this wonderful sacrament of the Holy Orders. Presentation. We have the hymn, Holy, 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 Nicaea, hymn number 266. Thank you.
Let him who is to be ordained priest come forward, Stephen Macias, to the title of the service of the Diocese of the Holy Trinity and Great Plains.
Present.
Reverend Father in God, I present unto you this person present to be admitted priest.
Take heed that the person whom ye present unto us be apt and meet for his learning and godly conversation, to exercise his ministry duly to the honor of God and the edifying of his church.
I have inquired concerning him, and also examined him, and think him so to be.
Brethren, if there be any of you who knoweth any impediment or notable crime in this person presented to be ordained priest, for the which he ought not to be admitted to that office, let him come forth in the name of God and show what the crime or impediment is. The declaration of submission by the candidate. Please.
I, Stephen Macias, do willingly subscribe to and declare that I assent to, and will obey and abide by the Constitution and canons which have been, or shall be from time to time, passed by the Holy Synod, or the Provincial Synod, or the Synod of the Diocese of the Holy Trinity and Great Plains. I, Stephen Macias, solemnly declare that I have not made by myself, or by any other person on my behalf, any payment, contract, or any promise of any kind whatsoever which, to the best of my knowledge or belief, is simoniacal, touching or concerning the preferment of ordination to the sacred order of priests. Nor will I at any time hereafter perform or satisfy in whole or in part any such kind of payment, contract, or promise made by any other without knowledge or consent. I, Stephen Macias, do believe the holy scriptures of the Old and New Testaments to be the word of God, to contain all things necessary to salvation, and I do solemnly engage to conform to the doctrine, discipline, and worship of the Holy Catholic Church Anglican Rite. I, Stephen Macias, swear that I will pay true and canonical obedience to the Bishop of the Diocese of the Holy Trinity and Great Plains and to successors in all lawful and honest commands. So help me God.
Dearly beloved, we commend to you and to your prayers this person who, according to our judgment, has been found need to be ordained priest, so that at the supplication of the whole church, God the Father Almighty may mercifully pour forth his grace and heavenly benediction upon this servant, his servant, whom he has been pleased to call to the holy office of priesthood. May the Lord favorably preserve him in the gifts of sacerdotal order he is to receive, that both by his life and doctrine he may show forth God's glory and faithfully fulfill this ministry to the benefit of his holy church. Let us kneel for the litany of ordination.
God the Father,
have mercy upon us.
O God the Son,
have mercy upon us.
O God the Holy Ghost,
have mercy upon us.
O Holy Trinity, one God,
have mercy upon us.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord, and that it may please thee to grant peace to the whole world and to thy church.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord,
that it may please thee to sanctify and bless thy holy church throughout the world.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord,
that it may please thee to implore all bishops, priests, and deacons with love of thee and thy truth.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
That it may please thee to endue all ministers of thy church with devotion to thy glory and to the salvation of souls.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
That it may please thee to bless this thy servant, now to be admitted to the order of priests, and to pour upon thy grace upon him, that he may duly execute his office to the edifying of thy church and to the glory of thy holy name.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
That it may please thee to guide by thy indwelling spirit those whom thou dost call to the ministry of thy church, that he may go forward with courage and persevere unto the end.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
That it may please thee to increase the number of the ministers of thy church, that thy gospel may be preached to all people.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
That it may please thee to hasten the fulfillment of thy purpose, that thy church may be one.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
That it may please thee to grant that we, with all thy saints, may be partakers of thy everlasting kingdom.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
Lord, have mercy upon us.
Christ, have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Hearken unto our voice, O Lord, when we cry unto thee.
Have mercy upon us and hear us.
O Lord, arise and help us,
and deliver us for thy name's sake.
Let thy priests be clothed with righteousness,
and let thy saints sing with joyfulness.
Lord, hear our prayer,
and let our cry come unto thee.
Let us pray. O God, who dost ever hallow and protect thy church, raise up therein through thy Spirit good and faithful stewards of the mysteries of Christ, that by thy ministry and example thy people may abide in thy favor and be guided in the way of truth. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the unity of the same Spirit, ever one God, world without end. Amen. Amen. We begin the Holy Eucharist. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. The Spirit of the Lord hath filled the whole world, and that which containeth all things hath knowledge of the voice. Alleluia, alleluia. Let God arise, and let his enemies be scattered. Let them also that hate him flee before him. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. The Spirit of the Lord filled the whole world, and that which containeth all things hath knowledge of the voice. Almighty God, unto whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. The Lord be with thee, and with thy spirit. Let us pray. Almighty and everlasting God, who has given unto us thy servants grace by the confession of a true faith to acknowledge the glory of the eternal Trinity, and in the power of thy divine majesty to worship the unity, we beseech thee that thou wouldst keep us steadfast in this faith and evermore defend us from all adversaries, who livest and reignest one God, world without end. Amen. Almighty God, giver of all good things, who by the Holy Spirit has appointed diverse orders of ministers in thy church, mercifully behold this thy servant now called to the office of priests, and so replenish him with the truth of thy doctrine, and adorn him with the innocency of life, and both by word and good example, he may faithfully serve thee in their ministry to the glory of thy name and the edification of thy church, to the merits of our Savior Jesus Christ, who liveth and reigneth with thee and the same Holy Spirit, world without end. Amen. O God, who in a wonderful sacrament hast left unto us a memorial of thy passion, grant, we beseech thee, so to venerate the sacred mysteries of thy body and blood, that we may ever perceive within ourselves the fruit of thy redemption. We make our prayer through the same thy Son, Jesus Christ, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the unity of the Holy Ghost, one God, world without end. Amen. Please be seated for the epistle.
The epistle is written in the fourth chapter of the book of Revelation, beginning at the first verse. After this I looked, and behold, the door was opened in heaven, and the first voice which I heard was as it were of a trumpet talking with me, which said, Come up hither, and I will show thee things which must be hereafter. And immediately I was in the Spirit, and behold, a throne was set in heaven, and one sat on the throne. And he that sat was to look upon like a jasper and sardine stone. And there was a rainbow round about the throne, in sight like unto an emerald. And round about the throne were 24 seals, and upon these seats. And I saw 24 elders sitting, clothed in white raiment, and they had on their heads crowns of gold. And out of the throne proceeded lightnings and thunderings and voices. And there were 7 lamps of fire burning before the throne, which are the 7 spirits of God. And before the throne there was a sea of glass like unto crystal. And in the midst of the throne and round about the throne were 4 living creatures full of eyes before and behind. And the first beast was like a lion, and the second beast like a calf, and the third beast had a face as a man, and the fourth beast was like a flying eagle. And the 4 beasts had each of them 6 wings about him, and they were full of eyes within. And they rest not day and night, saying, Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty, which was and is to come. And when those beasts give glory and honor and thanks to him that sat on the throne, who liveth forever and ever, the 24 elders fall down before him that sat on the throne, and worship him that liveth forever and ever, and cast their crowns before the throne, saying, Thou art worthy, O Lord, to receive glory and honor and power, for thou hast created all things, and for thy pleasure they are and were created. Here endeth the epistle. Blessed are the people whose God is the Lord, and blessed are the folk that the Lord hath chosen to him to be his inheritance. By the word of the Lord were the heavens made, and all the hosts of them by the breath of his mouth. Alleluia. Come, Holy Ghost, fill the hearts of thy faithful people and kindle in them the fire of thy love. Alleluia. Thank you.
Please arise.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The Holy Gospel is written in the third chapter of St. John, beginning at the first verse.
Glory be to thee, O Lord.
There was a man of the Pharisees named Nicodemus, a ruler of the Jews. The same came to Jesus by night and said unto him, Rabbi, we know that thou art a teacher from God, for no man can do these miracles that thou dost, except God be with him. Jesus answered and said unto him, Verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. Nicodemus saith unto him, How can a man be born when he is old? Can he enter a second time into his mother's womb and be born? Jesus answered, Verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born of water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter the kingdom of God. That which is born of flesh is flesh, and that which is born of the Spirit is spirit. Marvel not that I have said unto thee, Ye must be born again. The wind bloweth where it listeth, and thou hearest the sound thereof, but canst thou not tell whence it cometh, whither it goeth? So is every one that is born of the Spirit. Nicodemus answered and said unto him, How can these things be? Jesus answered and said unto him, Art thou a master of Israel, and knowest not these things? Verily, verily, I say unto thee, We speak that we do know, and testify that we have seen, and ye receive not our witness. If I have told you earthly things, and ye believe it not, how shall ye believe if I tell you of heavenly things? And no man hath ascended up to heaven, but he that came down from heaven. Even so the Son of Man which is in heaven. And as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, even so must the Son of Man be lifted up, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have eternal life.
Praise be to thee, O Christ.
Please be seated. Step up rather short so that I can also see the people.
No, you're fine.
Ye have heard, brethren, as well as in your private examination, as in the exhortation which was now made to you, and in the holy lessons taken out of the gospel and the writings of the apostles, of what dignity and of how great importance this office is, whereunto ye are called. And now again we exhort you in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, that ye have in remembrance into how high a dignity and to how weighty an office and charge ye are called. That is to say, to be messengers, watchmen, and stewards of the Lord, to teach and to admonish, to feed and provide for the Lord's family, to seek for Christ's sheep that are dispersed abroad, and for his children who are in the midst of this naughty world, that they may be saved to Christ forever. Have always, therefore, printed in your remembrance, Steve, how great a treasure is committed to your charge, for they are the sheep of Christ, which he bought with his death, and for whom he shed his blood. The church and congregation whom you must serve is his spouse and his body. And if a child happen that the same church or any member thereof do take any hurt or hindrance by reason of your negligence, ye know the greatness of the fault and also the horrible punishment that will come and ensue. Wherefore, consider with yourselves the end of the ministry towards the children of God, towards the spouse of the body of Christ, and see that ye never cease to your labor, your care, and diligence until ye have done all that lieth in you according to your bounden duty, to bring all such as are all shall be committed to your charge, and to that agreement in the faith and knowledge of God, and to that ripeness and perfectness of age in Christ, that there be no place left among you, either for error in religion, or for viciousness in life, for as much as then, as your office is both of so great excellency and of so great difficulty, you see, with how great care and study ye then ought to apply yourselves as well to show yourself dutiful and thankful unto the Lord, who hath placed you in so high a dignity, as also to beware neither you yourself offend, nor be occasion that others offend. Howbeit, ye cannot have a mind and will thereto of yourself. For that will and ability is given of God alone. Therefore, ye ought and have need to pray earnestly for his Holy Spirit. And seeing that ye cannot by any other means compass the doing of so weighty work pertaining to the salvation of man, but with doctrine and exhortation taken out of the Holy Scriptures, and with a life agreeable to the same, consider how studious ye ought to be in reading and learning the Scriptures, and in framing the manners both of yourselves and of them that specially pertain unto you according to the rule of the same Scriptures. And for this self same cause, how ye ought to forsake and set aside as much as ye may all worldly cares and studies. We have good hope that ye have well weighed these things with yourselves long before this time, and that ye have clearly determined by God's grace to give yourself wholly to this office whereunto it hath pleased God to call you, so that as much as lieth in you, ye will apply yourself wholly to this one thing, and draw all your cares and studies this way, and that ye will continually pray to God the Father by the mediation of our only Savior Jesus Christ for the heavenly assistance of the Holy Ghost, that by daily reading and weighing the Scriptures ye may wax riper and stronger in your ministry, and that ye may so endeavor yourself from time to time to sanctify the lives of you and yours, and to fashion them after the rule and doctrine of Christ, that ye may be wholesome and godly examples and patterns for the people to follow. And now, that this present congregation of Christ may also understand your mind and will in these things, and that this your promise may the more move you to do your duty, ye shall answer plainly to these things which we, in the name of God and of his church, shall demand of you touching the same. Do you think in your heart that you are truly called according to the will of our Lord Jesus Christ and according to the canons of his church, to the order and ministry of priesthood?
I think it.
Are you persuaded that the Holy Scriptures contain all doctrine as necessary for eternal salvation through faith in Jesus Christ? And are you determined out of the said Scriptures to instruct the people committed to your charge, and to teach nothing as necessary to eternal salvation, but that which you shall be persuaded may be concluded and proved by the Scripture?
I am so persuaded, and have so determined, by God's grace.
Will you then give your faithful diligence always so to minister the doctrine and sacraments and the discipline of Christ, as the Lord hath commanded, and as this church hath received the same, according to the commandments of God, so that you may teach the people committed to your cure and charge with all diligence to keep and observe the same?
I will so do by the help of the Lord.
Will you be ready with all faithful diligence to banish and drive away from the church all erroneous and strange doctrines contrary to God's word, and to use both public and private admonitions and exhortations, as well to the sick as to the whole, within your cures as need shall require and occasion shall be given.
I will the Lord be my helper.
Will you be diligent in prayer and in reading of the Holy Scriptures and in such studies as help to the knowledge of the same, laying aside the study of the word and the flesh?
I will endeavor so to do, the Lord being my helper.
Will you be diligent to frame and fashion your own self and your family according to the doctrine of Christ, and to make both yourself and them, as much as lieth in you, the wholesome examples and patterns of the flock of Christ?
I will apply myself thereto, the Lord being my helper.
Will you maintain and set forward, as much as lieth in you, quietness, peace, and love among all Christian people, and especially among them that are or shall be committed to your charge?
I will so do, the Lord being my helper.
Will you reverently obey your bishop and other chief ministers, who according to the canons of this church may have the charge and government over you, following with a glad mind and will their godly admonitions, and submitting yourself to their godly judgments?
I will so do, the Lord being my helper.
Almighty God, who hath given you this will to do all these things, grant also unto you the strength and the power to perform the same, that he may accomplish this work which he hath begun in you, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters, may I invite you to please stand and pray while we pray for the anointing of the Holy Spirit upon this deacon who is about to be ordered to the holy order of priesthood. Brethren, let's pray together in our hearts to God that upon this man whom he has chosen for our assistance and for the benefit and the further advancement of your salvation, he may shed forth the benediction of his Holy Spirit, so that he may receive the gifts and the powers of his sacerdotal grace needful for the order and ministry of priesthood, and what he has undertaken and promised at his gracious call may he fulfill and accomplish by means of his heavenly aid. As we sing Come Holy Ghost, hymn number 218, let's pray for the outpouring of the Holy Spirit, and Deacon Steve will lay prostrate, and we shall leave. Now, you see that if you want, and while he is prostrating, and you can pray. Let us pray. Almighty God and Heavenly Father, who of thine infinite love and goodness towards us has given to us thy only and most dearly beloved Son, Jesus Christ, to be our Redeemer and the author of everlasting life, who after he had made perfect our redemption by his death and was ascended into heaven, sent abroad into the world his apostles, prophets, evangelists, doctors and pastors, by whose labor and ministry he gathered together a great flock in all parts of the world to set forth the eternal praise of thy holy name. For these so great benefits of thy eternal goodness, and for that thou hast vouchsafed to call this thy servant here present to the same office and ministry, appointed for the salvation of mankind, we render unto thee most hearty thanks. We praise and worship thee. We humbly beseech thee, by the same thy blessed Son, to grant unto all which either here or elsewhere call upon the holy name, that we may continue to show ourselves thankful unto thee for these and all other thy other benefits, and that we may daily increase and go forwards in the knowledge and faith of thee and thy Son by the Holy Spirit, so that as well by this thy minister as by him over whom they shall be appointed thy ministers, thy holy name be forever glorified, and thy blessed kingdom enlarged to the same thy Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the unity of the same Holy Spirit, world without end. Amen. Please continue to pray for the outpouring of the Holy Spirit as we lay our hands on Deacon Steve Messias, praying for the gift and the anointing of the Holy Spirit to the Holy Order of Priesthood. Receive the Holy Ghost for the office and work of a priest in the Church of God, now committed unto thee by the imposition of our hands, whose sins thou dost forgive, they are forgiven, and whose sins thou dost retain, they are retained. And be thou a faithful dispenser of the word of God and of his holy sacraments in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Take upon thee the yoke of the Lord, for his yoke is easy and his burden light. Take thou this priestly vestment, whereby charity is signified, for God, by his power, is well able to bring his love to perfect fulfillment in thee, and give thee a good work.
Thanks be to God.
These hands are going to be consecrated. These hands will bless. These hands will absolve. These hands will consecrate the bread and wine into the precious body and blood of Christ, which will be given for the nourishment of our souls. And so we consecrate with the holy chrism oil. May the Lord vouchsafe to consecrate and sanctify these hands by this anointing of our blessings, so that whatever they shall bless shall be blessed, and whatever they shall consecrate may be consecrated. In the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. The consecrated hand of the priest will be bound. Take thou the authority to preach the word of God and to minister the holy sacraments in the congregation where thou shalt be lawfully appointed thereunto. Take thou the authority to offer sacrifice to God and to celebrate the Eucharist, both for the living and the dead, in the name of the Lord. Dearly beloved, we present unto you Father Stephen Messias, a priest in the Church of God. Let us together with the newly ordained priest renew our faith in the living God. Let us arise as we recite the Athanasian Creed, being the Holy Trinity Son. Thank you. Let's begin. Whosoever will be saved, before all things it is necessary that he hold the Catholic faith, which faith except everyone do keep whole and undefiled. Without doubt he shall perish everlastingly. And the Catholic faith is this, that we worship one God in Trinity and Trinity in unity, neither founding the persons nor dividing the substance. For there is one person of the Father, another of the Son, another of the Holy Ghost. But the Godhead of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost is all one, the glory equal, the majesty co-eternal. Such as the Father is, such is the Son, and such is the Holy Ghost. The Father uncreate, the Son uncreate, and the Holy Ghost uncreate. The Father incomprehensible, the Son incomprehensible, and the Holy Ghost is incomprehensible. The Father eternal, the Son eternal, and the Holy Ghost eternal. And yet they are not three eternals, but one eternal. As also there are not three incomprehensibles, nor three uncreated, but one uncreated and one incomprehensible. So likewise the Father is almighty, the Son almighty, and the Holy Ghost almighty. And yet they are not three almighty, but one almighty. So the Father is God, the Son is God, and the Holy Ghost is God. And yet they are not three gods, but one God. So likewise the Father is Lord, the Son is Lord, and the Holy Ghost is Lord. And yet not three lords, but one Lord. For like as we are compelled by Christian charity to acknowledge every person by himself to be God and Lord, so we are forbidden by the Catholic religion to say there be three gods or three lords. The Father is made of none, neither created nor begotten. The Son is of the Father alone, not made, not created, but begotten. The Holy Ghost is of the Father and of the Son, neither made, nor created, nor begotten, but proceeding. So there is one Father, not three fathers, one Son, not three sons, one Holy Ghost, not three Holy Ghosts. And in this Trinity, none is before, after other, none is greater or less than another. But the whole three persons are co-eternal together and co-equal.
So that all things, as is before said,
the unity in Trinity and the Trinity in unity is to be worshipped. Ye therefore, that will be saved, must just think of the Trinity. Furthermore, it is necessary to everlasting salvation that we also believe rightly in the incarnation of our Lord Jesus Christ. For the right faith is this, that we believe and confess that our Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of God, is God in the name,
God of the substance of the Father, begotten before the worlds, and man of the substance of his mother, born in the world.
Perfect God and perfect man, of a beautiful soul and human flesh subsisting, equal to the Father as touching his Godhead, and inferior to the Father as touching his manhood, who although he be God and man, yet it is not two, but one Christ. One, not by conversion of the God into flesh, but by taking of the man into God. One altogether, not by confusion of substance, but by being his first person.
For as the beautiful soul and flesh of one man,
so God, man, is one Christ, who suffered for our salvation, descended into hell, rose from the dead. He ascended into heaven, he sitteth at the right hand of the Father Almighty.
From whence he shall come to judge the living and the dead,
and whose coming all men shall rise again for their bodies, and shall give account for their own works.
This they that have done good shall go into the life everlasting,
and they that have done evil into everlasting fire. This is the Catholic faith, which except man who is faithfully, he cannot be saved. Glory be to the Father, and the Son, and to the Holy Ghost,
as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever.
Remember the words of our Lord Jesus Christ. Christ, how he said, it is more blessed to give than to receive. Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and give glory to your Father which is in heaven. Amen. The offertory. Please be seated.
Thank you.
Please be seated. We are very delighted to have this ordination here at St. Paul's. And the St. Paul's has a new priest and also a headmaster for the Canterbury School. We thank the congregation, the vestry, Mrs. Johnson, and the vestry senior warden, and all the members of the church family for hosting this event here at your beautiful church, St. Paul's. We remember Bishop Johnson with gratitude today, and we'll be praying also during the Holy Eucharist for him. And we thank the Lord for the wonderful gift of this church family. And I want to extend a word of praise and thanks to the parents of Deacon Steve Messias, and also his in-laws, and his wife, and all the children who are present in witnessing this wonderful sacrament. So we are very delighted. I extend to you the greeting from the Diocese of the Holy Trinity and Great Plains, and of the Holy Catholic Church Anglican Rite. You have been in our prayers all along, and so is Father Stephen Messias. So we need to get used to calling him Father Messias from now onwards. And so we are very delighted that God has given such a wonderful blessing to this church family. And we pray that the church may continue to grow in love and strength and going forward. And that's what we wish. So we are very thankful to the Lord. Let us continue to celebrate the Holy Eucharist for as an act of thanksgiving, which is the Eucharist itself means a thanksgiving. And therefore, let us offer this Eucharist as a thanksgiving, especially for this blessing that we have in Father Stephen Messias. Now, as to the page where we are at the bottom of page 11. So for this and all other intentions, brethren, pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Father Almighty. May the Lord receive the sacrifice at my hands to the praise and glory of his name, both to our benefit and that of all his holy church. Amen. Let us pray. Pray for the whole state of Christ's church.
Almighty and ever-living God, who by holy apostle has taught us to make prayers and supplications and to give thanks for all men, we humbly beseech thee most mercifully to accept our alms and oblations and to receive these our prayers, which we offer unto thy divine majesty, beseeching thee to inspire continually the universal church with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord. And grant that all those who do confess thy holy name may agree in the truth of thy holy word and live in unity and godly love. We beseech thee also so to direct and dispose the hearts of all Christian rulers that they may truly and earnestly administer justice to the punishment of wickedness and vice and to the maintenance of thy true religion and virtue. Give grace, O Heavenly Father, to all bishops and other ministers, that they may, both by their life and doctrine, set forth thy true and lively word, and rightly and duly administer thy holy sacraments. And to all thy people, give thy heavenly grace, and especially to this congregation here present, that with meek heart and due reverence, they may hear and receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. And we most humbly beseech thee of thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succor all those who in this transitory life are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity. And we also bless thy holy name for all thy servants departed this life in thy faith and fear, beseeching thee to grant them continual growth in thy love and service, and to give us grace so to follow their good examples, that with them we may be partakers of thy heavenly kingdom. Grant this, O Lord, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate.
Amen.
Amen.
Ye who do truly and earnestly repent of your sins, and are in love and charity with your neighbors, and intend to lead a new life, following the commandments of God, and walking from henceforth in his holy ways, draw near with faith and take this holy sacrament to your comfort and make your humble confession to Almighty God, devoutly kneeling.
Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, maker of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge and beware of our manifold sins and weaknesses, which we from time to time most previously have committed by thought, word, and deed against thy divine majesty, provoking most justly thy wrath and indignation and justice. We do earnestly repent, and are heartily sorry for the enormous doings. The remembrance of them is grievous unto us. The burden of them is intolerable. Have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. For thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please thee in the newness of life, to the honor and glory of thy name.
Jesus
Christ, our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of his great mercy hath promised forgiveness of sins to all those with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness. And bring you to everlasting life. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Hear what comfortable words our Savior Christ said, that all who truly turn unto him, come unto me, all you that travail and are heavy laden, and I will refresh you. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, so that all who believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Here also what St. Paul said, this is a true saying and worthy of all men to be received, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Here also what St. John said, if anyone sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the propitiation for our sins. The Lord be with thee.
And with thy
spirit. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up unto the Lord.
Let's give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is meet and right so to do.
It is indeed very meet, right, and our bounden duty that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Everlasting God, through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who with thine only begotten Son and the Holy Ghost art one God, one Lord, in trinity of persons and in unity of substance, for that which we believe of thy glory, O Father, the same we believe of the Son and of the Holy Ghost, without any difference of inequality. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and singing. Chant 796. God, our Heavenly Father, for the thou, of thy tender mercy, didst give thine only Son, Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made there, by his own oblation of himself once offered, a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world, and is instituted in his holy gospel, command us to continue a perpetual memory of that his precious death and sacrifice until his coming again. For in the night in which he was betrayed, he took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." My Lord, my God, have mercy on me. Likewise, after supper, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink ye, all of this, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as often as you shall drink it in remembrance of me."
Wherefore, O Lord and Heavenly Father, according to the institution of thy dearly beloved Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, we, thy humble servants, do celebrate and make here before thy divine majesty, with these holy gifts, which we now offer unto thee, the memorial thy Son hath commanded us to make, having in remembrance his blessed passion and precious death, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, rendering unto thee most hearty thanks for the innumerable benefits procured unto us by the same. And we most humbly beseech thee, O merciful Father, to hear us, and of thy almighty goodness vouchsafe to bless and sanctify with thy word and Holy Spirit these thy gifts and creatures of bread and wine, that we, receiving them according to thy Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. And we earnestly desire thy fatherly goodness, mercifully to accept this our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, most humbly beseeching thee to grant that, by thy merits and death of thy Son, Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we and all thy whole church may obtain remission of our sins and all other benefits of his passion. And here we offer and present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice unto thee, humbly beseeching thee that we and all others who shall be partakers of this holy communion may worthily receive the most precious body and blood of thy Son, Jesus Christ, be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction, and made one body with him, that he may dwell in us and we in him.
Remember also, O Lord, thy servants and handmaidens who have gone before us with a sign of faith and a restless sleep of peace. Bishop Johnson and all the dear departed members of St. Paul's Church family, Reverend and Mrs. Bill Banks, we beseech thee, O Lord, that unto them and to all such as rest in Christ, thou wilt grant a place of refreshing, of light, and of peace, and vouchsafe to give unto us some portion in fellowship with thy holy apostles and martyrs, and with all thy saints within whose fellowship we beseech thee to admit us. And although we are unworthy through our manifold sins to offer unto thee any sacrifice, yet we beseech thee to accept this our bounden duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses through Jesus Christ, our Lord. By whom and with whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, all honor and glory be unto thee, O Father Almighty, world without end. Amen.
Amen.
Let us pray. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
World without end. Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with thee and with thy spirit. May this be in consecration of the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ be unto us, with Lord, unto everlasting life. Amen. Let us sing the Agnus Dei. Together pray the prayer of humble access.
We do not deserve to come to this thy table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in thy manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much to gather our crumbs on thy table, but thou art sitting, O Lord, who commanded us always to have mercy. Grant us therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of thy dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our sinful bodies may be made clean by his body, and our souls washed through his most precious blood, and that we may evermore dwell in him, and he in us.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him that taketh away the sins of the world. Lord, I'm not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof, but speak the word only, my soul shall be healed. Lord, I'm not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof, but speak the word only, my soul shall be healed. Lord, I'm not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof. Let's speak to the Lord, my soul shall be healed. All those who are baptized are welcome to receive the Holy Communion this morning and believe in the presence of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, his precious body and blood being offered for us. Please come. Let's sing the hymn number 89 at the Lamb's High Feast. Of the Book of Common Prayer. Glory be to God on high, and on earth peace, goodwill towards men. We praise Thee, we bless Thee, we worship Thee, we glorify Thee, we give thanks to Thee for Thy great glory.
O
Lord God, Heavenly King, God the Father Almighty, O Lord, the only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, O Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, thou takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. Thou that takest away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. Thou that sittest at the right hand of God the Father, have mercy upon us. For thou only art holy, thou only art the Lord, thou only art Christ, the Holy Ghost, our most high, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Most merciful Father, we see thee said to send upon this thy servant, thy heavenly blessing, that he may be clothed with righteousness, and that thy word spoken by his mouth may have such success, that it may never be spoken in vain. Grant also that we may have the grace to hear and receive what he shall deliver out of thy most holy word, or agreeable to the same, as a means of our salvation, that in all our words and deeds we may seek the glory, thy glory, and the increase of thy kingdom, through Jesus Christ, O Lord. Amen. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Depart in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed be the name of the Lord from this time forth forevermore. Our help is in the name of the Lord who hath made heaven and earth. And may the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, keep our hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. And may the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Ghost descend upon us and remain with us now and always. Amen.
Amen.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us arise and proclaim the last gospel. This gospel was the hymn of the church at Ephesus of St. John the Divine. So we together proclaim the last gospel. It will become also part of our memory, part of our proclamation also. The Lord be with thee.
And with thy spirit.
The beginning of the Holy Gospel according to St. John.
Glory be to thee, O Lord.
We pray all together. In the beginning was the Word,
and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shined in the darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. There was an man sent from God, whose name was John. The same came for a witness, to bear witness to the light, that all men should be might believe. He was not that light, but was sent to bear witness of the light. That was the true light, which lies for every man that cometh into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made like him, and the world knew him not. He came into the world, and his own received him not. But as many as received him, to them gave he the power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name, which are born not of blood, nor of the will of flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God.
And the Word was made flesh, and dwelt among us. And we have beheld the glory of the only begotten and Father, full of grace and truth. Thanks be to God. Processional hymn number 384.
Oh,
sin, and protect us from all needless anxieties, as we wait in joyful hope for the glorious